Hello, everybody, and welcome to Bishop Guertin High School in Nashua, New Hampshire, scene of tonight's quarterfinal game between the host Lady Cardinals of Bishop Guertin and the visiting Dover Green Wave. It is the quarterfinals. You win three more games and you're state champions, but of course that's a lot easier said than done because of the top talent that you have to go through to get to Southern New Hampshire University on March 12. Bishop Guertin earned their way into this game by defeating Keene in the opening round 54-25, and Dover got here by winning their opening round game over Manchester Central 38-32. These two teams met earlier this season on Groundhog Day, February 2nd, and BG's hoping for a repeat of Groundhog Day, on which they defeated Dover in Dover by 16 points. So this is a rematch, but this one is for keeps, as it's a single elimination basketball tournament. 8 minutes up on the quarter scoreboard, and Dover with the opening possession, trying to score first here in this quarterfinal round game. Lots of excitement going on this Saturday, March 5th, as we record this. And Lipinski, Ali Lipinski, the senior guard, got called for the travel on Dover's opening possession. So it is a turnover, and still 0-0 as we've opened this up a half a minute into the game at Bishop Guertin High School on a Saturday night. A great crowd on hand, as you would imagine. I'm John Collins, along with our camera crew, Tim O'Neill and Frank Wallens. Abby Fields pass nearly intercepted. Molly Dehy off the glass gets her own rebound. Abby Field with a second chance, and she hits. It's Abby Field with a field goal, and we're underway on the scoreboard. 2-0, Bishop Guertin leads it. Underneath, Dover has it, trying to get their first basket of the game. Comes out to Allison Benson. Allison's shot misses, long baseline, and we have a whistle. A foul's gonna be called, as the ball was loose underneath the basket. A non-shooting foul is gonna go against Molly D. First team foul, first foul for anybody in the game. So Dover's gonna inbound underneath the BG basket. And the Green Wave have it, maneuvering, trying to find an open shot. BG's got tremendous player-to-player, one-to-one defense, and you'll see that all night, swarming the basketball, not allowing any wide open shots. Case in point, Molly D swats that pass out of bounds, had her left hand in the passing lane, and Dover forced to inbound it again. Still not able to get a quality shot off. The steal on the inbounds pass. Abby Field up ahead to Marie LaPlante. Double teamed, backs it out. Now underneath, Megan Cram's pass attempted to Molly D. Good steal by Allie Lipinski. He got down low, probably where Megan never saw Lipinski go into the passing lane and steal that away. Perimeter passing for Dover Green Wave. Lipinski trying to back in, gets it outside. Number 10 is Caitlin McDermott. The shot is taken right on line by Becky Cook, but it's in and out. Back rim, Marie LaPlante, bounce past Molly D. Marie gets it back and hands it off to Carolyn Hoffer. Molly D return pass to D. Too dangerous, stolen away by Becky Cook. Cook's got it, stops, pops, and Abby Field with the rebound, stolen away by Lipinski, who's getting down low underneath everybody and making a couple of steals. In rhythm, Molly D took a body check after she let go of that. It's out of bounds off of Guertin. So frenetic pace here, but only one basket to show for it for either team. Bishop Guertin up 2-0, 2.5 minutes into the opening of this game. Dover bringing it down court. Lipinski changes direction, gets it into the corner for the open three-point attempt for Allison Benson. No good. Abby Field right in the right spot for that rebound. Carolyn Hoffert, long diagonal pass, finds D in the corner, gets the return pass and goes right back to Molly inside Abby Field, turning around with the shot. Swish! Abby Field's got both baskets to begin this game. Two field goals make it 4-0, Bishop Guertin. 5 minutes even left to go, first quarter. Molly D got a fingertip on that ball, but Dover gets it back. Becky Cook with it, hands it off to Lipinski. Inside, Molly D, great defense. D is for defense on that play, and Molly got a hand on it. In the corner, Megan Cram back to Abby Field. Brad Crick, the head coach, calling out some instructions to Megan in the corner, who's got to keep an eye on the coach and the ball at this point, or at least an ear on Brad, the head coach, who's down off camera to our left here. Molly D, long cross-court pass, finds Marie LaPlante. Baseline bouncer to Megan Cram, does a good job of keeping that inbounds. Carolyn Hoffer is going to dribble through traffic, threads a bounce pass to LaPlante. Dover is similar with the man-on-man defense, very difficult to get a wide open look. Molly D driving baseline, draws a double team, bounce pass, Cram for the basket. Great ball movement by BG, produces their third basket of the game, and they're pitching a shutout right now, 6-0 halfway through the first quarter. Molly D, another near steal there by the talented junior forward for Bishop Guertin, number 25, one of many stars on this team. Dover cannot get free for an open shot. We got a foul. Molly got a little bit aggressive there on the defending and got a hand check on the wrist. It's her second foul of the first quarter. And she's going to take a breather now. It gets a nice hand from the BG crowd for some work well done. Megan Cram and Molly D come out. Rachel Marion is into the game, as is Megan Donovan. Steal, Megan Donovan with it. Head up, bouncing it down court. Looking for an open teammate, finds Carolyn Hoffer, the trailer. Bounce pass baseline, another bounce pass. Field with an open look, the left-hander. 6 points for Abby Field. Timeout by Dover's head coach, Daniel Casey. A great start to the first quarter for Bishop Guertin. They are up 8-0 here to begin this contest. Thank you for joining us. This is Nashua ETV. You can watch any of our games anywhere, anytime, online at nashua.easystream.com. As we listen to the entertainment provided by the Bishop Guertin Band and the stands across from our camera position here, you'll see some handheld shots from Frank Wallen down on the court as well. Mention a lot of excitement going on sports-wise on this Saturday night, March 5. The Boston Celtics are taking on LeBron James in Cleveland. The Boston Bruins are taking on Alex Ovechkin and the Capitals at the TD Garden in Boston. Simultaneous to this game, North is taking on Londonderry elsewhere in the quarterfinals of New Hampshire Girls Basketball Division I. So North looking for the upset there against Londonderry to try to advance against the Bedford Merrimack winner. And that next game, if North survives, if BG takes care of business on their home court, will be 5 days from now on Thursday, March 10. The quarterfinal series of games will be played at Southern New Hampshire University in Manchester. Dover looking for their first points of the game, having difficulty even getting a pass away with this tenacious BG defense, the steal. Carolyn Hoffer, the fruits of her team's labors there on defense, picks up the loose ball. Marie LaPlante bounce pass. Hoffer has it, being marked closely by Abby Cook, number 12. Now Dover switches off. Megan Cram trying to drive off the glass, no good. Rachel Marion with the put in. Great positioning by BG, and they've got a double-digit lead, 10-0. No points yet for Dover with only 2:20 left to go in the first quarter. An errant pass. The pressure being put on the ball by BG is just overwhelming for the Dover offense. They have no points and a lot of turnovers, and BG looking to go up 12-0. Marie LaPlante gets fouled as she threads her way through traffic underneath. The Green Wave having their hands full with all of these BG players. Abby Field takes her first breather, and she gets a well-deserved round of applause. And she has 6 of BG's first 10 points in this first quarter. With 2:09 remaining, Marie LaPlante inbounding the ball. Does a good job of finding Megan Donovan up top. Diagonal pass, Rachel Marion going to work, backs it out. Marion looking for an open teammate, finds Marie LaPlante. Buys some room over there on the sideline with some nifty dribbling. Drops it off. Megan Donovan driving the floater. Misses to the right. Rebound, Katrina Krenzer of Dover. The Green Wave looking for their first points as they move the ball around. Underneath, it's Krenzer off the glass and in, so Katrina was a force on the defensive end, and she ends up getting the first points of the game for Dover on the offensive end. 2-10-2. Guertin, the Lady Cardinals up by 8 points with 1:25 to go first quarter. Rachel Marion driving. Kicks it out to Marie LaPlante. She had three teammates open on that drive, did Marion, as she drew a double team. Carolyn Hoffer driving, puts it up and gets fouled. Good decision making with the basketball by Carolyn Hoffer. She recognized the seam, the lane to dribble through the defense. She put it up off the glass, nearly got a chance at an old-fashioned three-point play. She'll get to shoot two from the line. There's one. Carolyn Hoffer makes it 11-2. Bishop Guertin is on top. Fine free throw shooting form. Carolyn Hoffer for the second of her two free throws. Makes them both, and it's at a 12-2 advantage. Back to double digits for the lead. Carolyn Hoffer with the steal. Megan Morelli in the corner, playing catch with Megan Cram. Carolyn Hoffer feeling good from three. Just long on the shot, long rebound, and a body check there. Dover had it, and Megan Cram colliding with Becky Cook gets called for the foul. Third team foul against Bishop Guertin. You get 7 fouls till you're in the penalty, or you get 6, and then on the 7th, it starts the parade to the free throw shooting line. But basically, the officials letting the girls play here early. Megan Cram nearly got the steal on the inbound pass. Good job by Abby Cook to retain possession. Looking for a teammate to drop it into. Abby Field denying the ball, but Katrina Krenzer saves it for Dover. With it, Caitlin McDermott, point guard and a senior for Dover, threw it inside and threw it away. Not able to connect with Abby Cook. Tenacious defense by Bishop Guertin, making every pass completion a chore for the Dover Green Wave. Down court comes Megan Donovan, looking for an open teammate. That'll be Megan Morelli, just long on the shot. 12-2, BG enjoys a 10-point lead with 20 left in the first quarter. Dover appears to be playing for the final shot, looking for just their second basket of the opening quarter. 10 seconds left. In the corner with it, Becky Cook. 7 seconds remaining. As the fans start to count it down, 4, 3, they're going to have to shoot it. They do, short on the shot. The buzzer sounds, and the first quarter is in the books. And what a tribute to BG's defense on the scoreboard. 12-2, the Lady Cardinals leading by 10 points, but more importantly, more significantly, they held Dover to only 2 points of offense in that first quarter. Devastating to Dover's chances to come up with an upset and advance in this tournament. Obviously, they're on pace to score only 8 points for the entire game at this rate of 2 per quarter. They've got to improve on the offensive end. Brad Crick, the head coach of BG, has got to be telling his girls something along the lines of keep doing exactly what you are doing. Another exciting athletic contest that's going on simultaneous to this game on Saturday night, March 5 of 2016. The battle for first place in boys hockey. The BG Cardinals boys ice hockey team are playing at Concord. Concord is 16-1. The BG boys ice hockey team is 16-1. What a great game ongoing up there, and that is what has taken the attention of our friend and colleague Tom King, who is covering that game and will take his wealth of knowledge from that game and the rest of the regular season into our playoff tournament, where we look forward to covering the Bishop Guertin Cardinals boys ice hockey team for however deep they may go in the tournament, whether they defeat Concord and get the top seed or end up with the second seed. A contested shot there is a foul against the Green Wave, and to the line, Megan Cram will be shooting free throws. The foul went against Becky Cook, the third team foul against Dover. Just underway, second quarter. BG looking to add to their 10-point lead, up 12-2 as Megan Cram misses the first one. And we'll get a second shot here. Brad Crick calling out, I believe, a defense, a 3-2, although they've gone man-to-man for most of the first quarter. Megan Cram hits her second free throw, and it's an 11-point lead, biggest of the game so far for the Lady Cardinals. It's a 3-2 zone, full court press they're putting on. Stolen away by Megan Cram. What heads up, hand-eye coordination, long pass though, and she saves it, goes out of bounds off of Megan Cram. Must have stepped out. Looked like she tried to take the ball and throw it off of the defender and have it go out of bounds off a green jersey, but it is Dover's ball. 7.5 minutes remain, first half. Dover trying to beat the full court press, and they just barely do. Coming away with it, Abby Cook. Going baseline, Caitlin McDermott off the glass. It gets spit out by that rim, and Katrina Krenzer can't get the put back. Dover getting multiple chances in this possession, and the foul committed by Abby Field, non-shooting foul. Fourth as a team against the Cardinals. 13-2, Dover looking for just their second basket of the game here in the second quarter. A whistle on the inbounds play. And a discussion between Brad Crick and the official, something on the lines of, we already gave him the ball, coach. I understand. Brad's a little hyped up, understandably. Brad Crick, who was a guest analyst for us in our previous BG game. It was a treat to have him in studio for a voiceover of BG's last win that we had on NHIAA TV. Long shot for Dover's Green Wave. Katrina Krenzer in the right spot at the right time for the putback field goal that makes it 13-4. Krenzer has both buckets for Dover in this half, in this game. Long shot by Rachel Marion for three. And Dover's second basket of the game is answered by Bishop Guertin's first three-pointer of the game. And the Lady Cardinals with their biggest lead of the night so far, up by 12, 16-4. Dover can't beat the full court press. It leads to another turnover. Rachel Marion doing the ball handling for the Cardinals. Dribbles it off her foot. Dives for it, gets it back with some good hustle on the floor. Coach Crick calling a play as Carolyn Hoffer going to work off a pick, and it's a moving pick against the offense. Megan Cram called for a little bit too much physicality. A push on the screen. You have to basically, if you're going to set a pick, you got to kind of stand there like a statue and absorb the contact. And you kind of saw Megan give it a little bit extra oomph, and I think that's her second foul. So five fouls as a team against Bishop Guertin. That's the one byproduct of playing tenacious man-on-man defense. You get a little bit over-aggressive at times, and the fouls start to pile up, which they have. Two away from the penalty are the Cardinals. Turnaround shot, in and out. Rebound, Marie LaPlante gets a hold of it. That shot attempted by Abby Cook for Dover. Marie LaPlante steps inside the arc and misses to the right. Abby Cook rebound for the Green Wave. And down court comes Caitlin McDermott. Senior guard for Dover, swings it across to Becky Cook. In the corner it goes. Becky Cook has it. McDermott. The three-point attempt, we got a push as the battle for the rebound went on underneath. Shot attempted by Allison Benson, number 23 for Dover. That was the sixth team foul against Bishop Guertin, so a non-shooting foul again, but from now on, every foul by Bishop Guertin will produce free throws for Dover, beginning with one-and-one situations on non-shot attempt fouls. Marie LaPlante trying to deny the ball, comes out, and Katrina Krenzer is denied the ball by good hands on the part of Carolyn Hoffer, who got in the passing lane. Rachel Marion will check in, and Megan Donovan will check out. as Dover inbounds this. 5:16 to go, first half. Allison Benson thought about the shot. She's got Carolyn Hoffer, nicked that pass underneath. The hook shot by Katrina Krenzer, no good. Rachel Marion rebound. Good job of boxing out by Rachel. Carolyn Hoffer's in the corner trying to go one-on-one. Kicks it back up top, Marie LaPlante. Looking for an open teammate or an open lane, either one. Switching directions, kicks it outside. Megan Morelli, around the perimeter it goes. Megan Morelli with it. Inside Abby Field, inside the three-point arc, gonna hand it off Carolyn Hoffer. Dover stepping it up on defense here. 16-4, BT trying to add to a 12-point lead. Abby Field's got it inside, now outside. Marie LaPlante dribbling in traffic. Has it stripped away by Becky Cook. Cook has it stripped away by LaPlante, but Marie gets called for the foul. Coming from behind, got a hand on the wrist, according to the official. One of three officials working this quarterfinal playoff game here in New Hampshire Girls Division I basketball. 4.5 minutes exactly remaining first half. We are in the 1-1. The officials just recognized that although that was not in the act of shooting, it is the seventh team foul against Bishop Guertin, and so Guertin in the penalty means Dover goes to the line. And the Green Wave must hit this first free throw to earn a second. No, it's a live rebound in a 1-1. And Marie LaPlante brings it down court, changes direction. Forced outside, Rachel Marion. Megan Morelli finds a seam. Morelli with the lay-in, gets fouled. Megan Morelli with good decision-making saw a parting of the Green Wave there and tried to exploit it with a dribble through the defense. Had a good look at the basket for the left-handed layup, but it just didn't go. Now she gets two free throws. That's in and out. Bree Welch will substitute into the game for the Lady Green Wave, as they only have 11 players on the Green Wave roster. The bus was late getting here. Instead of a 7 p.m. start, it was a 7:30 p.m. start because of the long trip from Dover. Rachel Marion got a good one or two hand slap on that pass, but Dover retained possession. After the free throws, it's a 17-4 Bishop Guertin lead, and now Dover with another miss. In the corner, Marion, Megan Morelli looking for an opening teammate or a shot. And Carolyn Hoffer inside, bounce pass, anticipating movement. Abby Field and Carolyn Hoffer had a miscommunication, but then Dover turned it right back over. Marie LaPlante with the floater high off the glass, no good. Green Wave coming out of their own end. Slowing it down a bit, Caitlin McDermott. It's been a devastating first half offensively for Dover. They have just 4 points, and of course, that is not going to get it done. They scored 31 in these two teams' only meeting of the season back on Groundhog Day. Dover put up 31 points, still lost by 16, but they're nowhere near on pace for 31 points at this point. Marie LaPlante thought she got all hand on the ball, but she got called for a hand on the wrist. It's Marie LaPlante's second foul, the eighth as a team against Dover. Still, it's a 1-1. Dover must hit the first one to earn the second one. Actually, she was in the act of shooting, they say, in and out, so it was not a 1-1. I don't know how that's a two-shot foul. 60-second timeout called here at the Kaliga Dome. So we take a break. Want to use this break to congratulate Bishop Guertin's Granite State Challenge trivia team. Bishop Guertin won the opening round of Granite State Challenge. They were up against, well, believe it or not, Dover as the, Nashua South that won their opening round against Dover. Bishop Guertin won their opening round of this year's Granite State Challenge, hosted by longtime host Jim Janot, over Dover, or over Central, 420 to 230. I am being, okay. Let me straighten this out. Nashua South's four members of the Granite State Challenge trivia team, Doty Ayed, Noah Tolerski, Sam McIntyre, and Nisha Devasia, won the 2016 opening episode of Granite State Challenge, 740 to 220 over John Stark. So South beat John Stark in Granite State Challenge's opening episode. And Bishop Guertin beat Dover in their opener of Granite State Challenge, 420 to 230. So it's going to be South against BG in the quarterfinal round of Granite State Challenge. Long shot is a good one. Megan Donovan answers back the one free throw made by Dover with a two-pointer, so it's 19-5. Bishop Guertin with a 14-point advantage here with 2:50 to go in the first half. Driving, Katrina Krenzer with a nice running right-hander. Found an opening through the defense, so 19-7. Bishop Guertin up by 12, but the Dover Green Wave finding ways to score now. Megan Morelli with the scoop shot draws another foul, going right to left in the paint. Dover Green Wave, the Bishop Guertin Granite State Challenge trivia team members are David Travers, Holly Boyven, Jeff Steiner, and John McCann. This is the education station, and we want to give credit where it is due academically to this Bishop Guertin team. How about that one spinning around the rim and out by Megan Morelli? She did hit one of two, and great hustle on the floor by Megan Donovan. The jump ball possession arrow favors Dover, but no lack of hustle there by Megan Donovan. So 20-7, Bishop Guertin with a 13-point advantage with 2:20 left in the first half. Caitlin McDermott, point guard for Dover, being guarded closely by Megan Donovan. Carolyn Hoffer bearing down on Abby Cook, who gets it inside. The turnaround nowhere near the rim. And Carolyn Hoffer is going to do the ball handling across midcourt. 2 minutes even to go, first half. The Cardinals of Bishop Guertin nursing a 13-point lead, but they turn this one over off of a BG player, according to the official. 1:50 to go now, first half, and the Green Wave again has to contend with this difficult full-court press being put on by Guertin. The catch and shoot, long on the shot, even a longer rebound. Katrina Krenzer has it stolen away by Rachel Marion. Down court it goes. Megan Morelli in rhythm, hits to the left of the basket. And Abby Field has it stolen away, and we have a whistle blown. Abby Field got taken down. And they call the foul on Abby Field, and nobody on the Bishop Guertin side of the ledger agreed with that call. It looked like a cross body block and a takedown of Abby Field, but after taking his sweet time to make the call, the official decided that it was a pull down, much to the disagreement and chagrin of the BG fans. Hitting the first half of the 1-1 was Abby Cook. The Dover Green Wave is well represented here tonight. Across from us, students and parents have shown up from Dover, made the long drive, and hitting both free throws and getting cheered on, Abby Cook makes it a 20-9 game. So Dover not yet in double digits scoring-wise. Carolyn Hoffer tried to find Megan Donovan in the corner. There just was not enough steam on that pass, or maybe she thought Megan was cutting to the basket. In any case, pass thrown away, and BG rolling out the red carpet to Dover to get back in this game, perhaps, or at least get into double digits. Bounce pass underneath, Katrina Krenzer got it open ahead of the field. And it's 20-11. A 9-point advantage for Bishop Guertin now as Dover catches momentum, and a body block called against Allison Benson. 55 seconds remains, first half. BG was ahead by as many as 14 points. That lead is down to 9, but they do have possession here with just under a minute left to go in the first half. Megan Donovan has it knocked out of bounds by Bree Welch, playing tight defense. Number 11 for Dover, got a hand on that. Long inbounds pass by Sarah Sherburn. Sarah Sherburn in rhythm for three. High bounce, rebound. Megan Donovan, great work. Megan Morelli driving and foul before the shot. That's a 7th team foul. I believe it's going to be a 1-1. So Megan Morelli will shoot a free throw. If she hits it, she will get a second. 43 seconds to go, first half. The Lady Cardinals are up by 9. Megan Morelli to shoot free throws. Misses, and the rebound is a jump ball possession arrow. Should be BG this time. And that's thanks to the fine hustle on the last jump ball by Megan Donovan. BG will retain possession here. Inbounding it, Sarah Sherbert, one of the co-captains of this team, a senior guard, inbounds it to Megan Morelli. 35 seconds left. Carolyn Hoffer outside to Sarah Sherburn. Megan Morelli is going to drive. Layup drill. Excellent court vision by Megan Morelli for an easy 2. 22-11. Bishop Guertin leads by 11. With 15 seconds left to go, Krenzer with a turnaround. Gets her own rebound. That one doesn't go either. 10 seconds left. Megan Donovan, Carolyn Hoffer, 5 seconds left. Hoffer dribbling to the left, inside. Marion won't get a shot away. The half ends. BG leads 22-11. It's the quarterfinal round of New Hampshire Girls Division I basketball. BG looking to advance to the semis on their home court. We'll take a break. You're watching NHIAA ETV Basketball. Don't go anywhere. An exciting conclusion coming up right after this break.
Hamilton was adopted from a rescue in 2008. He really likes to be around people. And as soon as I start to make my breakfast, Hamilton is right there. I get out my mat and I'm doing a downward dog and he's underneath.
He's quite the pug about town. He gets invited to a lot of parties.
He knows he's a pretty big deal. I mean, look at this little face. How could you not love him?
Everyone, and welcome back to Bishop Guertin High School in NHIAA, New Hampshire, for the second half of this quarterfinal playoff game between the host Lady Cardinals of Bishop Guertin and the Dover Green Wave. It's a 22-11, 11-point lead for BG as we begin the second half. The Green Wave to inbound this thing to begin the third quarter. Dover had all kinds of trouble scoring in that first half due to the tenacious and smothering BG defense, and the Cardinals picking up where they left off, force a turnover as Dover gets called for traveling. That's how the first half and the first quarter began. So Bishop Guertin trying to add to a 22-11 lead. Marie LaPlante doing the ball handling, hands it off to Megan Cram. Megan, one of the few players who actually did some warm-up shooting before the start of the second half. There's a basket. Carolyn Hoffer was already sprinting down court to play defense when she heard the whistle blow and realized that she was going to be given the opportunity for an and-one three-point play. Our camera crew, Tim O'Neill and Frank Wallen. Frank down on the court with the hand held, and Tim right up next to me at midcourt. Carolyn Hoffer calmly completes the three-point play. I'm John Collins, missing my partner Tom King tonight because he's got a hugely important assignment for the newspaper. He is covering the Concord BG boys hockey final game of the season to determine first place up in Concord. Abby Cook hits a basket, so Dover answers back. Megan Cram for three, off to the left. Loose ball, Megan gets it. Driving for a lay-in, gets fouled. BG leads 25-13, and Megan Cram with free throws to shoot here to try to add to that 12-point lead. 7-11 to go, third quarter. In that boys hockey game, both teams are 16-1, so whoever wins that game will end up with the top seed in the Division I boys ice hockey tournament, which we will also be covering here on NHIAA TV. Of course, BG boys hockey team is the defending champion. The Bishop Guertin Cardinals trying to go all the way as the number one seed in girls basketball, up by 27-13, back to their biggest lead of the game of 14, which they also enjoyed during the first half. In rhythm for three, Caitlin McDermott, and a very vocal Dover Green Wave fan base that have made the trip from the Seacoast are heard on that shot make by McDermott. Molly D with a brilliant left-handed driving layup. 29-16. Guertin up by 13 points. Dover trying to beat that 3-2 full court press that the Lady Cardinals have been putting on all game. In the corner, Abby Cook, bounce pass underneath, running out of room was Becky Cook. Long shot, an air ball picked up by Abby Field. Finds Marie LaPlante, has some dribbling space. In the corner, Molly D gets it inside. Megan Cram with the turnaround hook, no good. That one's bounced off of a BG player's leg. Good call by the official, I think. And it is still Dover basketball. Well, actually, I thought it went off of the leg of a BG player. So, in any case, the Cardinals will take it. And doing the inbounding is Carolyn Hoffer. Marie to Megan Cram, back to Carolyn Hoffer, who hustled all the way over to the other side of the court. Marie LaPlante holding the ball over her head. Inside, Megan Cram. Facing up against her defender, swish. Right on target. Megan Cram makes it a 31-16 lead, biggest of the game for Guertin, up by 15. Bounce pass stolen. Molly D. Bounce pass to Megan Cram, and foul committed, baseline by Dover. Non-shooting foul. Second as a team, or team's third, by Dover. Katrina Krenzer will check back into the game. She was the most effective player for Dover down low in that first half. Only a freshman at 6 feet tall. Nice put in. Molly D cutting to the basket on the inbound play. 33-16. Molly D with the steal. Megan Cram tried the hook shot, got fouled. And she will go to the line for two. Free throws. The wheels coming off of the playoff train a bit here for Dover. And Dover wants a 30-second timeout to discuss things or try to interrupt the momentum. Brad Crick wanted to check on whether it was a 30-second or a full timeout. As we look in on the huddle also of Dan Casey, the head coach of Dover, trying to discuss with the Green Wave what they can do differently to cut into this 17-point deficit now. Points have been hard to come by for Dover because of the tenacious, relentless defense being played by Bishop Guertin. It is a Saturday night, March 5th, as we record this. A lot of excitement in the sports world As simultaneous to this game, Nashua High North girls are taking on Londonderry in a battle for survival in the quarterfinals in Londonderry. As Megan Cram sinks the first of two free throws and makes it an 18-point lead, 34-16. The winner of that game will be playing the winner of the Londonderry North game will be playing the winner of Bedford against Merrimack. The winner of this game, BG Dover, will take on the winner of Winneconnet versus Pinkerton going on right now. Getting the roll off the glass was Caitlin McDermott. And the senior guard will go to the line. I believe in the stands of Dover, they have one of those cutout blow-up portraits of Caitlin McDermott. Those things are amazing. I always marvel at the fact that not only can you get them from pro players now, you can get the idea is to take a photograph, a best photograph of somebody, a face, and get it extra large size that you can bring it on a stick or a signpost and wave it around to root your player on. And in what could be the final game of Caitlin McDermott's high school career, she is putting up her best effort, and she has a great fan support base that have made the trip here to Bishop Guertin High School to support her in the effort. There's a lot of green here. It's a St. Patrick's Day just around the corner as we record this. Of course, it's only 12 days away, March 17, and both teams have the green theme going in force. Megan Cram on the beautiful feed from Molly D, and Megan won't miss that shot too often. From behind, Rachel Marion with the steal. Megan Cram with her heads up, and she has it stolen from behind. A lot of pickpocketing going on here, like it's the streets of London in Charles Dickens' days. Gotta watch out for that basketball if you're dribbling down court in traffic. The officials are letting them play, and there's a lot of reaching in and taking away the basketball. Right now, Dover has it underneath their opponent's basket. Caitlin McDermott in the corner. Has it slapped away by Molly D, steals it. Molly D dribbling in traffic, has it in turn. What do we got? A foul call, and it's going to be against Molly D. And there's a few come on refs being talked about. You're talking about scrambling for a loose ball where nobody has possession. And Molly D got called for the foul, and some disagreement from the home fans. Molly's out of the game for the moment. I think that's her third. Megan Donovan playing energetic defense on the inbound pass, which comes into Abby Cook. Dribbling it near side, holding it over her head was Allison Benson. Up top, Cook dribbles around the perimeter. Caitlin McDermott, Marie LaPlante, and Megan Cram on her, beats the double team with a bounce pass. Inside, the turnaround, Krenzer, no good. Rachel Marion wrestling for the rebound, and we have foul called against Dover. Loose ball foul called. ...35-18. Bishop Guertin leading by 17 points with exactly 4 minutes to go third quarter. We're halfway through the third quarter. Bounce pass Marion. Up top is Carolyn Hoffer. Twisting and turning, finds Marie LaPlante. Not much breathing room for anybody with the basketball in this game, but Marie LaPlante finds Megan Cram. Megan lays it in and gets fouled. What brilliant offensive basketball we are seeing from this Bishop Guertin Lady Cardinal team, not only tonight, but all season long. Marie LaPlante drawing some defenders her way, and just about a no-look pass to Megan Cram underneath to set up the basket and the foul, 3-point play in the offing. They want to change who the scorekeeper and the public address announcer thought the foul was on. It was actually on Caitlin McDermott, according to the official. And Caitlin may be in foul trouble, so they're going to bring another Dover player out to take her place momentarily. I hope she didn't foul out. She's getting greeted as if she did. We are only halfway through the third quarter, and senior guard Caitlin McDermott taking a seat right now, getting a standing ovation. I hope she did not foul out. It's way too early in the game for that. It's a bounce pass that goes off the foot of Rachel Marion, who got in the passing lane. 38-18. Bishop Guertin's up by 20. And inbound play comes to Abby Cook. Katrina Krenzer with a great pass. Katrina Krenzer, how did she even see Allison Benson underneath? And Dover's got 2 points. Well earned. Down by 18, though. Lady Cardinals with an 18-point lead, 38-20. As they pass the ball around the perimeter, Carolyn Hoffer calling for Megan Donovan to come her way as the Cardinals put on a play here. Rachel Marion gets it to Carolyn. Megan Donovan back to Rachel, looking to bounce pass it into Carolyn Hoffer. She does get it in there. Carolyn with the scoop shot gets fouled. The reverse lay-in attempt. And the BG fans appreciate that effort. Nearly another brilliant three-point play by Carolyn Hoffer. 2:58 to go third quarter, and the Cardinals looking to add to their 38-20 lead. Shooting free throws. Carolyn's first is no good. Also going on tonight, besides the BG boys hockey game against Concord and the Nashua North Londonderry girls basketball game, in the pro sports world, you got the Bruins against Ovechkin and the Capitals, and the Celtics taking on LeBron and the Cavaliers on March 5, 2016. Down court come the Green Wave. They just barely keep it inbounds. Immediately double-teamed was Allie Lipinski in the corner, and a timeout called by Dover, more to retain possession than anything. Dover burning some timeouts here early in the second half, or relatively early. We're still in the third quarter. 39-20. BG's up by 19 points. Would seem to comfortably have this game in hand. These two teams met on Groundhog Day, the one and only time this season, and Guertin won by 16 points in that one. So they're looking for a Groundhog Day repeat. In other games in the opening round of the tournament, Alvern was the home team, the sixth seed against Merrimack, and were upset at home in Hudson, losing 55-39, while Bedford dispatched South 52-27 in the opening round. North beat Memorial 59-42. Londonderry got past Exeter easily, 53-26. Winneconnet over Trinity, 53-43. Pinkerton beat Salem, 45-23. Dover got to this game by beating Central 38-32, and BG took care of business in the opening round at home against Keene, 54-25. Megan Donovan did a nice job of denying the ball to the inside player, but got called for the foul, for a blocking foul in the process. That is the third team foul against BG, which has three more team fouls to give before they're in the penalty, so they're in good shape there. Dover has six team fouls, so the next foul they commit, Cardinals will be going to the line. Katrina Krenzer just lost the handle. A turnover by Dover. And now the Cardinals have a chance to go up by 20 or more points with possession, leading 39-20. Megan Cram has it, looking for an open teammate. Moves to the left, splitting the defense. Megan Cram's going to go all the way to the bucket. 41-20. The Cardinals are up by 21 points here with 2:10 to go in the third quarter. Dover had a nice spurt near the end of the first half, but they've not seen Lady Momentum on their side since. Guertin getting it done defensively and offensively, and Mary LaPlante goes crashing to the floor. Took a forearm to the side of the face, you'd never know it, as Marie LaPlante wins back possession for the Cardinals. And Megan Donovan will do the ball handling, going one-on-one with Allie Lipinski. Runs out of room, will change direction. Megan Donovan with the left hand off the glass and in. A ball handling clinic there by Megan Donovan. The inbound play by Dover. As Allison Benson changes direction, takes the shot, miss off to the left. Rebound on the floor. Dover can't get the put in, and Megan Morelli comes out of the crowd with the ball. Marie LaPlante took a bit of contact there. They let it go. Marie LaPlante splits the D. The floater doesn't fall. Good looking drive, but a difficult finish. And Dover back with possession, down by 23 points. The feet underneath. Abby Cook gets it outside. Katrina Krenzer, swish. 43-22, back to a 21-point advantage for the Cardinals with possession. Rachel Marion runs out of room. Her bounce pass unintentionally goes to Megan Donovan. It was intended for Megan Morelli. Marie LaPlante's going to slow it down just a little bit here. Takes a breather, bounce pass Donovan, threading her way, basket. Difficult lay-in, but Megan Donovan gets it to go. 45-22, the Cardinals up by 23 points, and just barely retaining her pivot foot on the ground was Peyton Aubin, number 3 in the game for Dover. Rachel Marion denying the ball, dives on the floor and gets a jump ball. The possession arrow favors Dover. But every jump ball that you earn is money in the bank for the next time the ball gets tied up. Marie LaPlante guarding the inbound pass by Peyton Aubin. Aubin throws it in, but Megan Cram steals it and lays it in. BG defense so good, so opportunistic. Marie LaPlante nearly had the catch and shoot before the buzzer, and that's knowing exactly how much time is remaining. As you can see, it's a commanding 25-point lead for the Lady Cardinals of Bishop Guertin on their home court here in the quarterfinals of New Hampshire Girls Division I basketball. 47-22. As the BG band entertains between the third and fourth quarters. Collins with Frank Wallen and Tim O'Neill, our camera crew here on NHIAA TV. You can see any of our games anywhere, anytime online at nashua.ezstream.com. Bishop Guertin inbounding the ball with the fourth quarter underway. It's an embarrassment of riches for BG. They've got possession of the ball and possession of a 25-point lead. But they squander a little bit of that right there with a turnover on the opening possession. And BG gets the favor returned by Dover right back. A turnover by Dover. And it's a Guertin opportunity again to score the first points of this fourth quarter. Molly D holding the ball in the corner. The cutting Megan Cram absorbs the contact and will go to the line. She was in the act of shooting it, so it will be two free throws to shoot for Megan Cram. It looked like a foul was called there against Allison Benson, number 23 of Dover. Green waved, 7 fouls as a team. BG with only 3 fouls as a team. As Megan Cram hits the first free throw. An excellent free throw shooter she has shown herself to be. Molly D, Megan Donovan, Sarah Sherburn, and Carolyn Hoffer are your five Bishop Guertin players to begin the fourth quarter. Megan Cram nails both of the free throws. 49-22. Bishop Guertin bearing down on defense like it's 0-0. Coach Brad Crick has got to be very pleased with 90% of this effort in this game. They've been showing all the signs of a top-seeded team on a mission to get a state championship. Megan Cram is in the left corner. Underneath, Molly D gets it right back out. One touch pass by Megan Donovan to Carolyn Hoffer. Back to Donovan again. D's open, driving baseline, gets fouled. Foul will be against Abby Cook. We'll listen to the public address announcement of whether Abby may be in foul trouble. Well, he said it. I do believe that we may have been right about senior point guard Caitlin McDermott fouling out of this game, because she is a key player for the Dover Green Wave, and she's had more than enough rest since the third quarter, her last foul that she committed, to come back into this game. And I would venture to say that Caitlin has fouled out. She received a nice round of applause for what I imagine was an excellent high school basketball career. Long cross-court pass for the Green Wave ends up in the hands of Peyton Aubin. Aubin to the cutting Abby Cook. Doesn't go. Gets the putback, though. Hard working basket by Abby Cook, the senior forward for Dover. 51-24. BG up by 27. And I think a good job by the official to see that. What do we got? An offensive foul? You got to be kidding me. I don't know about that call. I did see Ella Sadish, the center senior there, stick her knee out just a little bit as Megan Cram drove to the basket. I don't totally agree with that offensive foul call at all. Three-point attempt, short on the shot. Allison Benson, and out of bounds, Dover. See a good shot of Tim Bush underneath the basket down there, along with Judge Joe LaPlante, Marie LaPlante's dad, taking in the game. A lot of familiar faces at this quarterfinal playoff game, including the boys basketball coach, Jim Mignol, who is seated across the way. Abby Field with the turnaround, misses off to the right. Megan Donovan with a really heads-up rebound, but then stepped out of bounds underneath the basket. So, a blocking foul called against Dover. So there was a reason that Megan Donovan went out of bounds, and they say it was because of a blocking foul. And because that's the eighth foul as a team against Dover, Megan Donovan is going to the foul line. Hits the first of the one and one. 52-24. A lot of time remaining in this fourth quarter, but it is a huge hill to climb if you are Dover, down by 18 points. Make it 19 with that free throw by Megan Donovan, who is coming out of the game. Awesome job is one of the things that Coach Brad Crick just said to Megan Donovan as she came out after hitting both of those free throws to make it a 19-point lead, 53-24. Dover with the ball. Carolyn Hoffer has got a smile on her face as she slid to the ground there in defense, or in defending against Allie Lipinski. Ball goes out of bounds off a BG defender. .5:24 to go, fourth quarter in the game. Ellie Sadish with the shot, misses long. Rebound Megan Morelli, Rachel Marion with it. Up ahead, Sarah Sherburn inside to Abby Field. Wrestles the ball away, and a foul's going to be called. Let's see who it's against. 1-4, that's Allie Lipinski. Called for the loose ball foul, and to the line will go Abby Field. That's only two fouls against Lipinski, but 10 fouls as a team against Dover, so this is going to be two free throws automatically for Field. Abby misses the first. BG is piling up the points here against Dover. That's going to be number 54 on the game. In their opening game, that matches the Guertin point total. 54-25, they dispatched Keene. The score of this game right now is 54-24. So a 30-point lead for the Cardinals. Dover in traffic. Elias Satish took a big hit after that and will shoot three free throws. Megan Morelli, in her desire to get a hand on that shot, drifted in midair right into the person of Ellis Satish. And that was a good call. So three free throws to come for the Dover center. Hits the first in fine form. Ella is a senior playing in her final high school game. Misses off to the right. We've got a third free throw here. Nice arc on those free throws by Ella. 54-26, 4:45 to go in the basketball game. Molly D changes direction. Rachel Marion thought about baseline. Instead, she'll go foul line area. Hits Molly D as they crisscross. Pass near side. Sarah Sherburn flicks it inside. The turnaround hook by Morelli is blocked cleanly by Allie Benson, who threw it away. And it'll be BG ball at half court. Fourth quarter, Bishop Guertin leading 54-26. Couple of substitutions for the Green Wave. And Abby Field coming out. Emily Moran is in. Molly D is out. And Kayla Bednarz is in. Abby and Molly getting a nice, well-deserved ovation for their efforts, helping to put Lady Cardinals up by 28 points on the scoreboard here with 4:10 to go in the game. Sarah Sherburn lost the handle momentarily, gets it back, bounce pass inside, and we had some body contact going on, and it's going to go against Dover. To the line goes Emily Moran, freshly into the game and newly to the free throw line to shoot two, as that was the 11th team foul against Dover. Emily misses her first free throw. Quarterfinals being played here on Saturday, March 5, as Emily Moran hits her second free throw, makes it a 19-point lead, 55-26. In the corner it goes. A lot of contact. They let him play. Loose ball's on the floor. Scooped up by Peyton Aubin, but she's in trouble. And a travel's called against the Dover guard underneath. A turnover and Bishop Guertin basketball. The semifinal game upcoming at Southern New Hampshire University will be played on Thursday, March 10th of 2016. At Southern New Hampshire University in Manchester. It'll be Bishop Guertin, no doubt, taking on the winner of the Winnicunnett-Pinkerton game, which is going on right now. That's a battle of a 4-seed and a 5-seed in Derry at Pinkerton Academy. So, at Winnicunnett on the seacoast in Hampton. They have the 4-seed, the higher seed, so they would host that game. With the ball, passing it was Jillian Lindquist, number 12 in the game for Bishop Guertin. Kayla Bednarz up top, Emily Moran driving, kicks it back out. But the Cardinals lose the handle and turn it over. Maggie Casey, who is a sophomore for Dover, into the game, number 44. Ellie Lipinski passes it into the corner. Peyton Aubin underneath. Ella Satish off the glass, no good. Rebound fought for. Loose ball and doing a Harlem Globetrotter dribbling display to retain possession there was Emily Moran. And she gets a nice round of applause for her dribbling skills. And nearly losing that one was Sarah Sherburne. The shot from three-point territory by Emily Moran doesn't go. Nice rebound by Guertin in the person of Brooke Barrett, the senior going to work. In the corner for three, Jillian Lindquist with a big smile after she sinks that one and puts Bishop Guertin up by a whopping 32 points, 58 to 26. 2 minutes and 20 seconds left to go in the game. Peyton Aubin of Dover with it in this quarterfinal round game. Set shot from the corner, or is a three-point attempt by Maggie Casey, doesn't find rim. And Jillian Lindquist, who just hit that three, hands it over to Kayla Bednarz, going one-on-one with Sophie Roy of Dover. Back to Kayla. Playing some catch with Jillian Lindquist, who just hit a three from there. Why not try it again? Oh, in and out. Nice rebound by Brooke Barrett in the corner with about a third shot for Jillian Lindquist. Oh, she's gonna take it out top and take some time off the clock. Baseline, Sarah Sherburne inside, the turnaround by Brooke Barrett is blocked. Abby Cook returns to the game for Dover as Peyton Aubin gets a nice hand coming off the floor. Kayla Bednarz will do the inbounding here. Minute and a half left to go in the game. As coach Brad Crick gets some more and more players into this contest to get some playing time in the playoffs. Bonus basketball. There's a ball off the glass, no good. Nice driving attempt by Brooke Barrett. Ella Satish gets help to her feet by a teammate and Emily Moran in a nice show of sportsmanship. 1:16 to go in the game, 58-26. BG with the lead, comfortably ahead of this one. As Allie Lipinski dribbles down court. Allie, also a senior, playing in her last high school game. Ella Satish wrestles the ball away from Kayla Bednarz, but not before Kayla earns a jump ball. Allie Lipinski will do the inbounding. And out of the game comes Sarah Sherburne, senior captain. Into the game comes Elizabeth Crokey, a freshman. Elizabeth getting some playing time here with a minute left. There's a high archer underneath that doesn't fall. Mad scramble for the loose ball. Won by Emily Moran. Up court by Jillian Lindquist. Elizabeth Crokey had an opportunity to shoot. Nice dribble, and oh, the students wanted her to hit that one after a great misdirection fake. The freshman in the game. Nice move. Dover with it. 35 seconds left to go in the contest. Ella Satish from the left corner. Elizabeth Crokey with the rebound and is fouled in the corner, and that means she's going to shoot some free throws. Liz Crokey to the line. 29 seconds to go. Elizabeth Crokey hits her first playoff free throw of her high school career that we have seen on NHIAA TV. There's a possibility that she might have got one last game against Keene. She hits them both, and it's a 60-26 lead for the Lady Cardinals with under half a minute left to go in the game. Shot from the corner doesn't go for Allie Lipinski. Elizabeth Crokey is going to have to beat a triple team to dribble this down court, putting on a display here, drawing some oohs and ahs. 7 seconds, And BG's going to be content to let the clock tick down. 3-2-1. And we go to the semifinals, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. The Bishop Guertin Lady Cardinals getting it done on their home court here in the quarterfinal round, defeating Dover 60-26. Terrific play by all of the Bishop Guertin players as a team. And Coach Brad Crick will take his team to play the winner of Winnicunnet-Pinkerton 5 days from now in Manchester at Southern New Hampshire University. For our A-plus camera team, Frank Wallant and Tim O'Neill, and our executive producer, Pete Johnson, I'm John Collins. Thanking you for watching. 60-26, Bishop Guertin with a quarterfinal win here on March 5, 2016. Good night from Bishop Guertin High School, everybody.